New Year's cake's tradition of Vasilopita with the lucky coin. We took the cakes to the Church of St. Saws on January 1st, where a prayer was said over them by the priest. This is after the Holy Liturgy. And I'd like to tell you a little bit of the tradition of what these sweet cakes of St. Basil are. It's a tradition. They're baked in Greece, Bulgaria, Cyprus, in the Mediterranean, and other areas of Eastern Europe and the Balkans, and they contain a hidden coin so that when you cut the pieces, the one who gets the lucky coin is supposed to have God's blessing and luck for the whole year. First we cut the piece for our Lord Jesus Christ, and then our Holy Mother, and then to St. Basil, and then to the saint of our church, and then to the priest, and then to going on to everyone that's in the room. And we also cut them at the house. We cut them for one piece for our Lord Jesus Christ. The first pita we cut in our reading room was between the pieces for Lord Jesus Christ and our Holy Mother. Now, when we cut at the house, we cut the piece for our Lord Jesus Christ, another for our Holy Mother, another one for the poor, another one for our home, another one for the father, the mother, and the children, going down the line, and the visitors and the relatives that we have with us, cutting the Vasilopita, the pita, the pie, with us. So it's we do this from January 1st onwards. In some regions, the traditions surrounding this cake with a hidden coin are attached to the Epiphany or to Christmas. It's made of a variety of doughs depending on the region. It tastes like egg bread that we have in New York, for example. Now, some families, instead of dough, it's made from custard-based milk pie. But in other areas of the Balkans, the tradition of the cake with a hidden coin during winter holidays exists associated with St. Basil. The ritual, the tradition, New Year's Day, families cut this cake, Vasilopita, to bless the house and bring good luck for the new year. It's usually done at the midnight on the turn of the new year. A coin is hidden in the cake by slipping it under the dough before baking, and at midnight the sign of the cross is etched with a knife across the cake. A piece of cake is sliced for each member of the family and any visitor present at the time, by order of age, from eldest to the youngest. Slices are also cut for various symbolic people or groups, depending on local and family tradition. They may include our Lord, St. Basil, and other saints, the poor, the household, or even the gremlin, the Christmas gremlins. Anyway, in older times, the coin often was a valuable one, such as a gold sovereign. Nowadays, it's just a prepared gift or money or a little bit of a coin, like a silver dollar or something, to be given to the recipient. Or there could be something expensive. When we were at a dinner one time, the coin fell to me, and the coin was actually a gold 24-karat gold pendant of, on one side it had our Lord Jesus Christ on the cross, the other side was King Constantine and his mother, St. Helen, holding the cross of Christ. So it was quite a beautiful and expensive thing, and that fell to me. Well, that was my luck. Now, many private or public institutions, such as societies, clubs, even schools, workplaces, companies, cut their Vasilopita, their traditional New Year's cake, at a convenient time between New Year's Day and the beginning of Great Lent, where everybody's gathered together and make a celebration of it. In celebrations that range from impromptu potluck gatherings to formal receptions and dances and balls. And St. Basil's feast day, as we know, is observed January 1st, the beginning of the new year, and the Epiphany season known as the Vasilopita observance. And I'll let you now listen to some of the psalms that were read during this blessing of the Vasilopita, the New Year's cakes.
Oh, ο πάσης εκτός μεταβολήστε των όντων και αλλοώς αλλοιώσεως, ο των πάντα χρόνων τε γεγονότατων τε όντα και των εσώμενων πληρών, ο ενδιαφάτος ο μακροθυμίαν και ταξιώσας ημάς εις νέων ενιαυτών του πλούτου της Χριστότητός ο εις ρεθήν. Αυτός, πανάγαθε δέσποτα, την είσοδον ταύτην τη Θεία σου χάρη ευλόγησο. Όμως ειρηνικούς προς εποχωρίαν, η γη δόρισε, τους αέρας υγιεινούς και ευκράτους ανθρώπιστε και εκτίμηση κατασκεύασον. Δώσ' ημίν εν ειρήνη και ομονία βεβαία των κύκλων αυτού διελθύν. Το στεφάν της δόξης των αρετών, κοσμωμένος το φωτί των εντολών σου, ευσχημόνους όσον ημέρα καλώς οδεύοντας. Το ευσεβέσιμο έθνος τη δυνάμει σου κρατέωσον, την νεότητα παιδαγώγησον, το γύρας περικράτησον, τους αλληγοψύχους παραμύθισον, τους εσκορπισμένους επισυνάβηγε, τους πεπλανημένους επανάβηγε και σύναψον τη Αγία σου Εκκλησία, ειν τη Θεία σου χάρη τη καλό σου διαφύλαξον, λάλησον αγαθά εν τες καρδίες των αρχόντων ημών, ενίσχυσον και ενδυνάμωσον αυτούστε και των φιλόχριστων ημών στρατών, ελθέτω εφημάς Κύρια η Βασιλεία σου, Βασιλεία αγάπης Χριστότητος, δικαιοσύνης και ειρήνης και αξίωσον ημάς ενινιστόμετη μια καρδία ημνήμησε και δοξάστησε το ενδριάδι άναρχον και όνειων Θεών εις τους αιώνας των αιώνων.
Αμήν.
Του Κυρίου δεηθόμεν.
Κύριε λαϊσόν.
Κύριε ο Θεός ημών, ο καιρούς και χρόνους εν γη διεξουσιεθέμενος και την ζωήν ημών εις Κύρα σου διακρατών, επάκουσον ημών δεωμένος σου εν τη ευσύ μου ημέρα ταύτην, επί τη εισόδο ημών εις το νέο ενιαυτόν της Χριστότητός σου και ευλόγησον τους πλακούντας τούτους, τους προσφερωμένους εις δόξαν συν και εμήν του εν Αγίης Πατρός ημών Βασιλείου του Μεγάλου Αρχιεπισκόπου και Σαρίας της Καπαδοκίας. Επίβλεψον μεγαλόδωρε εξ ουρανού Αγίου σου και κατάπιμψον εφημάς τους τεταδόρα ταύτα ευτρεπίσαντας και τους εξαπών μεταλαμβάνοντας τας ουρανίους δωρεάσουν ότι επισυλπήκαμε. Το ζώντι Θεό εις τους αιώνας, ευλόγησον τας εισόδους και εξόδους ημών, πλήθυνον εν αγαθή στην ζωή ημών, κατεύθυνον τα διαβήματα ημών προς εργασίαν των θείων σου εντελών, ότι ουκ απάρτο μόνο ζήσετε άνθρωπος. Πρεσβείες εις Παναχράντος ο Μητρός, του Αγίης Πατρός μου Βασιλείου του Μεγάλου, η πάνω σου των Αγίων. Αμήν. Εις πάνω ο Θεός, εις ο Θεός, ανοιχτή το όνομα Κυρίων.
Το όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένο από τον ήλιο και του αιώνα. Το όνομα Κυρίου ευλογημένο από τον ήλιο και έως του αιώνα.
Αρχή πριν τη μυθήνη κατά δεξάμενος διάθυμος σωτηρίαν Χριστός ο αληθινός Θεός ημών της πρίσβησης Παναχράντων και Παναμώμα Αγίησα των Μητρός, τον Αγίνων Δόξων και Πανεφήμων Αποστόλων, τον Αγίνων Δόξων και Καλλινίκων Μαρτύρων, τον Οσίων και Θεοφόρων Πατρών ημών, τον Αγίης Πατρός ημών Βασιλείων, Αρχιεπισκόπου και Σαρίας Καπαδοκίας Κορονοφάντος των Μεγάλων, ούκριν επιτελούμενου, των Αγίων και Δίκαιων Θεοπλατών Αθηνικιάνης, των Αγίου Μάρτυρων Σώζοντος, του Αγίου Πρωτομάρτυρου του Διακόνου Στηφάνου, της Αγίας Όσου η Πρωτομάρτυρος Παρασκευής, των Αγίης Παδός Ιωνικά Άρτης Αποκριμές, Γιαβρού και Θεμόντος Κούρου, και πάνω των Αγίων, ερήσει της Ωσιμάς, ως αγαθός και φιλάνθρωπος και λιήμων Θεός. Χρόνια πολλά, βοήθειά μας.
Again, Happy New Year to all of you. Health, happiness, prosperity, and the best of everything, and God's blessings to all of you. Thank you for your support. Please ring the bell to make sure that you get my updated videos, and make sure that you're subscribed, and please share and comment. Thank you. If you'd like to join me on my Patreon account, you will hear content not covered by mainstream media. These riveting stories will be based on my research, and I will state my opinions and give my personal insight on diverse and controversial subjects and world events, events not covered by mainstream media, and not certainly on not supported by YouTube guidelines. So whatever I have on my Patreon, most of those will not be on my YouTube channel. Please consider becoming a member today. More of the most significant and important videos will be on my Patreon channel. Your support helps me to continue my research and keeps this YouTube channel alive. And we depend on your support, your generous charity, because we help economically challenged families here in Athens, Greece, in Kapota, and we also help the young generation with university tuition and the community around our church. Thank you.